So it just so happens that on Christmas they celebrate, at least here in Nassau, a kind of a tradition called Junkanoo, which is also the name of a beach here. And they have like 16 or 12 different groups that kind of put like these big floats together, and like second place will win like $60,000, and the first place wins like $100,000. So we've got these cool floats relating to different traditions, like African traditions, and there's one that's like even like Disney. So it's a bunch of a kind of a hodgepodge of cool floats for Junkanoo, so celebrated on Christmas. So let's check out some of those. Just in case you need to get your hair braided before you get on the cruise ship. So, it's formal night. It is Christmas night. It's a full moon. And we're about to go up to dinner in the main parking, or not, not in the main parking lot, in the main dining room to have dinner. We actually already just came back from dinner at the buffet. So we were so hungry after walking around Nassau and you know, swimming and going to visit Atlantis and walking and finding and searching all that. So, you know, and then we only had like some teeny sandwiches for lunch. So we were pretty hungry and pretty beat. So we ate like a ton of food. The mashed potatoes are just great. I really love the mashed potatoes. So now we're gonna go for second dinner. Nothing wrong with second dinner. And, you know, just kind of pick through what they have. Yesterday for dinner they had, well, not for dinner, but like you get to pick between like 8 starters and then like 8 entrees or something like that. And so I got one of the starters. It was like called watermelon soup. I've never heard of watermelon soup, but it was so good. It was cold, but it was like the teeny tiniest amount. And then the dinner plate was pretty small too. So actually I was really hungry after we left dinner. You know, I was like still ready to continue eating after we left dinner yesterday. So it's kind of a good thing that we're all filled up and ready to go, so we can just kind of pick through the whatever they got tonight. So anyway, Merry Christmas. I know this is coming after Christmas, but Merry Christmas. Happy holidays to those who are not celebrating Christmas, and it's dinner time. I'm gonna get this one.
You are ready.
This one.
You're ready here?
Yes.
For you, sir.
Can you go ahead?
Would you go ahead on the
chicken for me? Yes.
Yeah, I'll get the
okay.
You are not together, I mean.
No, we just meet on board.
Two.
Look at that pretty blue Bahamian water. It's just absolutely gorgeous. It's actually more turquoisey blue on the in real life than on camera. I can see a fish down there too. So we're actually docked like a little bit of ways. Today is the day at Coco Key, or Coco Cay, I'm not sure which it's actually pronounced. So we've docked farther away because they don't have a port. And we're gonna take what's called a tender, a little boat to get in. And Amra and I rented jet skis. So we're gonna go jet ski around for an hour and hang out on the beach, and we leave early today, so we'll probably come back on board maybe around 3. Oh, and we get a lunch is provided today on the island. It's like a barbecue, and they have, you know, like the Bahamian style cooked macaroni and cheese and bunch of other stuff. So that'll be exciting. And then we're just gonna come back and rest. We've been doing like so much that I'm kind of feeling like a little sick or something, or not quite sick actually yet, but if I were to like continue waking up early and like running from here to there, it's actually been a little hectic. So I'm trying not to do that. We're just gonna rest a little bit. Oh, there's a mermaid on that. On that rock. So we're enjoying a little bit of tropical or Caribbean rain. Yay! yay! But it's still actually pretty warm, even though I have my sweater on. In the ocean, there was a fish that like kept getting stuck in the tide, and so it saved its day to get back out to sea. But that was kind of cool. I got to like hold it. You know, I held it under the water. But anyway, I'm going to be going over here to get on the jet ski soon. And just have fun. Do you like my sunglasses? They're like the cheap ones from Target, and they keep cracking. I don't even know when they're cracking, but you know, I keep them in my car, and like once in a while I get in my car and I'll put them on, and like I realize that they're broken again. So I think it's just like cracking from the heat or something. So I'm hoping on the jet ski the glasses stay on, but whatever, they're only $5 anyway from Target, so. So I just got back into the room after breakfast, and they've left a little penguin towel doing the splits. Actually, the other day it was like a little dog. So they're pretty skilled in the art of towel origami. And then this stuff, this is like, you get something like what you're gonna do every day. Oh, actually this is like for coming back in the US. Cause we're at Key West today. You can kind of see there was really strong winds, so we're actually coming in later. You can see it's already like a really beautiful kind of turquoise water. So that's exciting. Check out beautiful, beautiful Key West. Here's the beach, and then a little key, and then another little key. All the sailboats. Really so beautiful. Oh my gosh. I just love the clouds are, they're just different at the beach. They're like kind of thinner, you know, just have their like beachiness. I just love them. So we're about to get off of the beach, I mean the ship, but because this is our first entry back into the US, everybody has to go through immigration. So it's like chaos down on, whichever deck, everybody's got different decks. So it's down to like chaos, like in the center areas where everybody's waiting for immigration. So I came up here because we're a little bit delayed anyway, and I thought I would just kind of take a view of everything above. It's like so beautiful. Man, yeah, if you haven't like seen this part of the world, or you know, like turquoise waters, it's just like my favorite, so totally recommend it. And here's like a, I think that's like called a catamaran. Here's a catamaran coming. Cruise ship behind. This is the muster deck. This is where everybody, you can see it says like muster on these signs up here. You're designated a muster station, and if the thing ever sinks, you gotta come up to deck 7. Apparently it's deck 7 on all cruise ships. Or I heard something like that. But yeah, it's not chaotic up here, so that's good for me. I like that. Man, it's just like so beautiful. I just can't get over it. There's a bunch of keys out there too. Maybe you can barely see them. Kind of little islands out there. So beautiful. So here we are on the other side of the ship in Key West. A lot more going on over here. We're going to go in the elevator. Oops. Going to number 3. Going to do immigration. This is kind of like the center of the... Wait. Is it not going? Maybe it's not working. Alright, that's weird. That sucks. I wanted to go down on the clear elevator. Alright. Oh my god. Okay, good. What if it didn't let me out?
A very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Carlos, your cruise director.
Let's see if it goes down.
This is Sammy. Can we request all guests from muscle station number 5, 6, 7,
all right, I better
eight.
Go down.
If you're holding a U.S. passport, you can go ahead and proceed to the dining room located on deck number 3. If you're holding a non-U.S. passport, at this time, we also call muscle station number 5, 6, 7, and 8 to make your way to the iPhoto's line theater located on deck number 5. Please make sure you take with you all the documents that you need for this mandatory inspection. Thank you and have a wonderful day out there in Key West.
You can buy $5 coffees over there, or like $8 coffees. Gonna head out biking through Key West. Can't wait. Here we are at Hemingway House, where Ernest Hemingway lived and wrote maybe one or two books. Well, he probably wrote more than one or two, but I think at this location he just wrote like one. There's like a really big long line. Don't know if we're gonna go in. It's much fun, much more fun cruising around on the bikes. It's so pretty here. Yo, these chickens are crossing the road. Taking a break from beach cruising and riding around town, we're gonna go get key lime pie over here at the Old Town Bakery.
Small one compared to the ones I saw down here.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah.
Thank you.
there's a cruise ship out there. Parked behind all the palm trees. So I just came back into the room and they made the bed and there's now a stingray towel. So they're being very fun and creative with the towels. After getting off the cruise this morning, we have like a 16-hour wait until the flight leaves. Like, we got off maybe about 8 o'clock, and flight leaves at almost midnight tonight. So unfortunately, there was none in the middle. But we decided to rent a car and drive into the Keys. We did just come from Key West, but you know, there's so many things to see, like just different kinds of beachy scenes and stuff. So we came out on the Keys and came all the way to the 7 Mile Bridge to see the True Lies scene and check that out and watch the sunset.